Hi friends, this is Anurag. So in this video I'm going to describe you that how you can use CRUD on the Rails console. In the previous video we started to creating a Rails Hello World application, and now in continuation to that video, now I'm going to describe you the CRUD on the Rails console. So let's start. So first of all, I am on the Rails root directory where I have created a project cd blog. I just came to the blog. Then I'm going to create a model called post. So let's create. I have written Rails G space model space post. So Rails G model is a command to Unix model, and post is a name of the model. We are using post as a singular here because model name should be singular and control name should be plural in this framework. So also we have to create field names at the post table. So basically when you run this command, you will find that the command will create a migration file for us with the field names which we are going to provide here. So I'm just going to write title, which is string kind of data type, and okay, so just title and just press on enter. Created a few bunch of files. You can see here, first of all, the migration file, the timestamp, then create, and then the post, the name which we provide with that command, with the plural post. Second one is a model file with a singular name, and two test reject files. So open the text editor. Let's close previous one. Closing all previous files. Let's open the app and model and post. So we can see here there's a class called post which is a singular, and that class post is inherited by active record base class in model. So basically that model class name should be singular always. Okay, then let's open the migration file after db migrate. You can see here this is a class called create post, and this method by active record migration class in model. Then there is a method called change, and in that method there is a method create table with the post parameter and with the field name which we provide at the time of the generation of the model. So the kind of string data type, and a title is a field name in the database. We can see here there is a timestamp field. This basically provides the timestamp field by default, the migrations. So we don't need to worry about created it and updated it timestamp fields in a database table. So basically the timestamps method creates the two fields called created it and updated it by default into the database table. Okay, so let's come on to the console. So basically now I'm going to start the console. So to start the console, we can write command this console, or we can just write this. So our console has been started in the development environment. Okay, so let's create a post. I have created a post with a class name dot new method. The new method basically is used to create a new object of the class. So here the class is post, and we are applying that method on the class post and passing parameters like attribute title and implementation side, and putting a name mark first post, and storing that variable in it, storing that object into a post variable. So let's create. Oh, so it's giving an error. So we got an error that could not find table post, because we don't have a table post, we just created a migration. So let's break that console, then run the migration first. So to run the migrations, command is break space db colon migrate. That command basically runs all the migrations which is not yet done. So we can see here that the create post migration has been migrated. Let's come onto the console again. Now we can see that we have an object with mail ID, the title which we provided at first post, created at mail, and updated at mail. We got these three nils because that object is not yet saved into the database. This object is only on the read-only memory. So putting thread, we have to save that object. So we can use post dot create instead of new methods. So here we can see that logs, there's an insert query with the fields provided by us and the values provided by us. And at last we can find the object of post, which is post. Now there's id 1 instead of nil, title which is the same as we provided, created it and updated it, because now that object has been saved in the database and updated in the database in the first time. Now let's move to the second thread operation, which is update. So now we have a post object which we can get by just typing post in the console. Now we are going to update the title of the value of the title attribute. So let's do it. Post dot update we are going to change my second post. Oops, error. So we can find the error, which is update attribute. Row number of argument 1 for 2. There should be 2 arguments for this method. Oops, this was an error. So according to that error, we should pass 2 parameter instead of 2. The first parameter is going to be title, and then enter again. So we can see that our transaction has been committed. Now see that object here. You can see here that title sorry, my second post has been updated into the database, and that updated at timestamp has been changed. Now the last thing in the thread operation is just delete. So we have post object saved in the post variable, Now we are going to delete it. But first of all, we need to check that how many objects are, or how many rows are existing in the database of the post table. So let's suppose check post.all. You can see here that post class and all method is returning an array of all the posts stored into the database. Let's check the size, post.all.size. Size is a method which we can apply on the on an array. So here we can see that it's returning the size 1 because we have only saved one object in the database. So let's give that post.destroy. So just click enter. We can see that again in the console that transaction has been committed and it's returning the object. Now check the length of the array, like the rows and the objects stored in the database. Post.size. It's a new row because that object has been deleted. So basically in this tutorial I have described you that how we can implement CRUD but on console, because we are before going to write a code in a file and move to the web page, firstly we need to understand the concept of CRUD on the console. Thanks for watching this video, and please feedback, give me some feedback so I will be able to improve my tutorial next tutorial. Thanks. Bye.